God, it's time to start. Let's all grab a songbook, stand together, turn to page number 180. Let's sing Everybody Will Be Happy Over There. It's good to see you in God's house tonight. Joy and privilege to be back in church. Amen. Sing it out good and loud now. There's a happy land of promise over in the great beyond, where the saved of earth shall soon the glory share, where the souls of men shall enter and live on forevermore. Everybody will be happy over there. Everybody will be happy over there. Mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, singing round the throne in that land where no one ever knows a care. And the Christians of all ages will join in the triumph song. Everybody will be happy over there. Sing that last verse now. There we'll meet the one who saved us, kept us by his grace, and he brought us to that land so bright and fair. We shall praise his name forever as we look upon his face. Everybody will be happy over there. Oh, sing it now.
Everybody.
Closest to hell tonight, but your name, amen.
You can be seated. Worship with the choir while they sing this evening. Let's sing page number 21, choir.
Thank you. shadows fall all around us. Darkness comes to hide our way. Don't despair, soon night is ending. The clearest sky
appreciate the good choir singing. Amen. And hey, we need to pray. Got a lot of folks got this croup right now, so we thought we'd give you a little bit of a break tonight. Amen. But that sure was two good songs, wasn't it? Amen. And thank God for the good choir. Let's all stand, and we're going to receive the offering tonight. And we got some special singers going to sing for us tonight, so you worship with them as they're getting ready to sing. And do want to mention, after the service tonight, we do need to meet with those that have been in the Christmas play. If you signed up for the Christmas play. We need to meet over in the fellowship hall for just a few minutes tonight. And so that also involves even the younger children. Isn't that right, Miss Gravley? That'll be in the Christmas play. So if you'll meet with us for about 5 minutes in the fellowship hall. And then also any of the preachers, if we could have you meet over in the fellowship hall with us as well. Want to just talk to you for just a minute. Brother Russell Townsend has a opportunity there for preachers to serve and work in the Walker State Prison and their program. And so I just want to take about 2 or 3 minutes to tell you about that. And if it's something that you're interested in being a part of, then certainly you can talk to us afterwards and you can get involved. All right, I want to give every preacher opportunity to be involved, to preach the gospel, and to help others. Amen. A lot of other announcements we made this morning, and so we won't go through all of them tonight. But do pick up a church bulletin so that you can keep up with those things. And I do want to ask you to continue to pray. Brother Dave McCurry, as most of you know, his sister went home to be with the Lord, and the funeral will be on tomorrow. And so let's pray for Brother David, remember him and his family in prayer. And then also continue to pray for Brother Dole Sisk. I want you to pray for him as he has been dealing with these tumors. And he texted me this afternoon and said he was just in a lot of pain and certainly needed our prayers. And then also want to pray for Brother Paul Lyons. Certainly remember him in your prayers. And Brother Laddie's here tonight, but if he's not here in the service, that is where he is at. He's taking care of Brother Paul. And so we certainly want to pray for him during this time. All right. I'm glad we serve a great big God. Amen. And nothing is too hard for the Lord. Amen. And think about Ephesians 3 and verse 20. When Paul was praying for the church at Ephesus, he said, "Now unto him that's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us." And certainly the power of faith can overcome a lot of things. Amen. And so let's trust the Lord for these people and these needs tonight. Let's pray for them. And you give in the offering as the Lord would have you to give. Still want to praise God this morning for meeting that $60,000 goal. Isn't that a blessing? And so we thank the Lord for that. And you give tonight as God would have you to give. We'll ask the blessing over the offering at this time. Brother Jason Gilruth, will you pray over the offering? Yes, Lord. Amen. You can be seated. Worship with them as they sing.
I'm no ruler or king.
Christ, He loves me as small as I am. He picks me up, wipes off my sin, puts me on my feet again. Yes, He loves me as small as I am.
There's been many trials I've faced since I started on this race. There's been times it seemed that no help was inside. There's been times that the valleys seem so long, dark and cold. But my Lord has been with me every step of the way. And it's been worth every mile. It's been worth every trial. It's been worth every valley that we've crossed. It's been worth everything that we faced in His dear name. And it'll be worth it all when we see His face.
There's been many friends I've had since I started on this way, who have said, I'll go with you all the way. But they've turned and now they're gone, leaving me standing all alone. But my Lord has been my friend all the way.
And it's been worth every mile. It's been worth every trial. It's been worth every valley that we've crossed. It's been worth everything that we face in His dear name. And it'll be worth it all when we sing His praise.
There's been many prayers I've prayed since He seems He did not hear. Many times it seemed the answer would never come. Many times I've grown weary and forgotten the prayers I prayed.
But my Lord remembers and answers every prayer.
It's been worth every mile. It's been worth every trial. It's been worth every valley that we've crossed. It's been worth everything that we faced in His dear name. And it'll be worth it all when we sing His praise.
Yes, it'll be worth it all.
Amen.
Tell it, brother. That's right.
To know God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank God, look down here. There's no body down here. Isn't that a blessing? We're not mourning a funeral, are we? We're celebrating a resurrection. Hallelujah. Thank God, no matter what you've been through in life, you can sing that song. It has still been worth every mile. It's been worth every trial. It's been worth every valley that we'll ever cross in this life. God's been good to us, hasn't he? Hallelujah. Sing that last verse. Let's give a word of testimony, if you would.
I just want to thank the Lord for everything he's done in my life. And yes. I just feel like I'm so unworthy for anything. And I just thank him that he just keeps blessing. He's answered some prayers for us lately. And I just praise him for it.
Amen. Praise God.
There's been many prayers I've prayed, and it seems he did not hear. Many times it seemed an answer would never come. Many times I've grown weary and forgotten the prayers I prayed.
But my Lord remembers and answers every prayer.
It's been worth every mile. It's been worth every trial. It's been worth every valley that we've crossed. It's been worth everything that we face in his dear name. And it'll be worth it all when we sing his faith.
Yes, it'll be worth it all when we sing his faith.
Amen. Let's get the bluegrass group adults. Y'all come sing one, and maybe somebody else give us a word and testimony or two while they're getting set up. All right? Yes, sir. Yeah. Hit man, brother. Tell it. Yes. Tell it, brother. Yes. That's right. Yep, man. Tell it, brother. Yes. That's right. Yes. That's right. That's it. That's right. He's worthy. Oh, yes. Yes. Yep, man. Me too. That's right. Yep, man. Yes, that's right. Oh, yes. Yeah. That's right. Yep, man. That's right. Yep, man. Yes, that's right. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yep, man. Doesn't cost us nothing to say amen, does it? Just reminded me when he said that. Used to, I worked in a carpet mill and get up at 4:30 in the morning, go to work, and come to work on Wednesday night, or come to church on Wednesday night, and I'd have my work clothes on like a lot of people and just barely slide in for 7 o'clock. And I'd sit down on that second pew there. There's a little side door you come in. I'd sit on that second pew, and in body, in flesh, you know what my flesh said? Every Wednesday night, my flesh said this to me. Said, now you've been working all day long. You're tired. You just sit back and you just, you know, listen to some good preaching and you just enjoy the message and rest. That's what the flesh, you know, flesh is always wanting you to rest, isn't it? And you know what? But I couldn't do it. When the preacher was up preaching, I just felt like he needed help. Y'all, about half of y'all with me on that. I just felt like the preacher needed some help when he got up to preach, and I felt like I just wasn't doing him right, sitting there on my blessed assurance while he preached, and I just sat there and just said nothing. I just felt like I amened on Sunday so I could amen on Wednesday, amen? And you know, just what he said, worship. Oh, you said you worship because you felt like it? No, but God's still worthy to be praised, didn't he? And I found out those Wednesday nights I'd go to church, wore out and tired, and my flesh said, be quiet and rest. And I'd just go ahead and do it out of obligation. I'd do it because it was the right thing to do. You know what? I always walked away blessed. I mean, God put a blessing on me. Amen. Not because, I'm not telling you, I wasn't nothing. Amen. And if you've done that, you know that's true. Amen. And hey, it works on Sunday night, works on Sunday morning. I know we're not going to get raptured out every service, but I'll tell you, we ought to just give a good amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Raise a hand every now and then. Doesn't cost me nothing to do that. Amen. He's just been too good to not get in on what God's doing. Isn't that right? And it works, doesn't it? And it works on Sunday, and it works for the singers, and it works for the testifiers. When somebody gets up to testify, I don't want to just sit there dead on them, amen. I feel like, hey, if they're telling the truth, I want to say amen, because amen means I agree with what you said. Now, if they say something I don't agree with, I'm not going to say amen to that. Isn't that right? But if it's in that book, and it lines up with the Word of God, and God gets the glory out of it, we ought to give a good amen every now and then, and let all the people say amen. Now, I'm not fussing. I'm just sharing that with you tonight. Isn't that good? I mean, because it's the Bible. And I'm not fussing at you. I feel like it's a good service, but I'm just saying I need to be reminded of that we always ought to be ready to worship, be ready to just back up what's going on. And y'all do a good job at that, but we still need to be reminded, because if we don't, guess what? We'll bury our church. One amener, one testifier at a time, it'll just dry it and die, won't it? Amen. I don't want it to be that way. And I want these young people coming up, I want y'all to know what it is. Stand up and praise God. Testify. Raise your hand in church. Say amen to the preaching. Isn't that right? And get involved in what's going on. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Thank you. to go down and stay by the brook. I'll see to your every need. Ravens will bring you food to eat. Don't get down on it. Just look to me and stay by the brook. Trials, troubles, and heartaches you must face. It could happen any moment. God's gonna get us out of this place. Stay by the brook, stay by the brook. God told Elijah to go down and stay by the brook. I'll see to your every need. Ravens will bring you food. They don't get down on it. Just look to me and stay by the brook. And stay by the
I'm a man, flesh and blood, of just one thing I'm sure. I was made from the dust, and the dust I will return. But the dust ain't the end, calls in my heart, I know. I'm spirit, and so to the Father's soul my go.
Be assured, if you're trusting in the Lord, all who call on His name are gonna live
in me. The spirit of the Son, that Son I'll ever be. Well, I can be assured that my home is up on high. I found it in the word of the one who'll never lie.
Be assured if you're trusting in the Lord, all who call on His name are gonna live forevermore.
If you live in the darkness and the fear, there's love from above, He will wash away your tears. Pouring love into you, the Spirit of the Son can flow through you and everyone.
Be assured, if you're trusting in the Lord, all who call on His name are gonna live forevermore.
for many long years in bondage. God's chosen people had been out in the wilderness wandering. 'Twas all because of sin. Their leader had been old Moses. But now that he had died, God said to Joshua, cross over to the other side. Cross over to the other side of Jordan. The Lord to Joshua said, cross over to the other side of Jordan. My people must be led, no longer in the wilderness wandering. From Egypt's bondage flee, and when you reach the other side, you shall be free.
The river now lies before you, the waters you control. Now is the time to cross over, the waters back will roll. A wonderful land is waiting just over Jordan's tide. Remember, victory lies over on the other side.
Cross over to the other side of Jordan. The Lord to Joshua said, cross over to the other side of Jordan. My people must be led, no longer in the wilderness wandering. From Egypt's bondage flee, and when you reach the other side, you shall be free.
Said to Joshua, look toward the setting sun.
All the nations that you see someday will be one.
Just as it was with old Moses, so I will be with thee.
I'll stand with you in battle, and I'll bring you victory.
Cross over to the other side of Jordan. The Lord to Joshua said, cross over to the other side of Jordan. My people must be led, no longer in the wilderness wandering. From Egypt's bondage flee, and when you reach the other side, you shall be free. And when you reach the other side, you shall be free.
Amen. Isn't that a blessing tonight? Praise God. Let's take our Bibles and turn to Philippians chapter number 2. Philippians chapter number 2 tonight. Appreciate all the good singing. And we'll turn there and take a few moments tonight and bring the message that God has laid upon our hearts. Philippians chapter number 2. And if you'll stand with us tonight in reverence to the reading of God's word and prayer, then you can be seated. Philippians chapter number 2. And we'll pick up our reading tonight in verse number 5. Philippians 2 and verse number 5. The Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. Being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Verse number 13. For it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Do all things without murmuring and disputings, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world, holding forth the word of life, that I may rejoice in the day of Christ, that I have not run in vain, neither labored in vain. Yea, and if I be offered upon the sacrifice and service of your faith, I joy and rejoice with you all. For the same cause also do ye joy and rejoice with me. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you tonight for the singing. We thank you for the offering, the opportunity to worship you tonight in spirit and in truth and in freedom and in liberty. And I pray now that you'll bless the reading of thy word, speak to our hearts, and we'll thank you for it. In Christ's name we do pray. Amen. Amen. You can be seated tonight. I want to preach a few minutes tonight on this subject, on the example of humility.
the example of humility. The first four verses, as we looked last Sunday night, talks about the importance of humility and why that we need humility in our life. We need it in our life because, according to verse 2, we need like-mindedness. And also, according to verse 2, we need that same love, as Paul mentioned there. We need that lowliness of mind in verse number 3 that the Bible talks about here. We need to be able to lift each other up as we esteem others better than ourselves, and we need humility in order that we might be able to look every man not on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. And so Paul here gives us the importance of humility in the early verses of this chapter here, but now in verse number 5, Paul is going to draw us to the example of humility, and that example is our Savior tonight. I would say that the greatest example of humility in all the Word of God is Jesus Christ. Amen. He came into this world, and as he came into this world, he came into this world as a servant, as a peasant, as a lowly man of Galilee, as a babe in Bethlehem. And so when we think about what a great example we see in these verses here tonight, notice with me in verse number 5, as we look at him, we see him as sovereign, as the Messiah. As the Bible said, let this mind be in you. Notice this, which was also in Christ Jesus. Amen. That word Christ means Messiah, and that is his heavenly name, and Jesus is his earthly name. And when we think about Christ Jesus, it does not say Jesus Christ, although that would be right, but he's elevating him of the mind of our Messiah, our Savior, as he came into this world. You know, that's the kind of mindset that we need tonight. We need the mind of humility. We need to think of ourselves on a lower level, and we need to think of others before us and above us. And so we see here tonight the example of this humility. We see it in the Savior, the Messiah, and then we see him as the Son of the Maker in verse number 6, as the Bible says, who being in the form of God thought it not robbery to be equal with God. When you think about Jesus Christ, Christ Jesus as our Savior in verse number 5, but we must be reminded that he was more than just a Savior. He was and is the only begotten Son of God. Amen. He's the Messiah, but he is the Maker. He was there at the very beginning when God stepped out on nothing and he spoke these worlds into existence. He looked at God the Son and he looked at God the Spirit and he said, let us make man in our own image. Amen. That tells me that Jesus Christ had as much to do with creation and the fulfillment of it as God the Father and God the Son. And so when we picture him, he's the creator of this world, but yet he came into this world and he humbled himself, the Savior, the Son of God, the Messiah, the Maker. When you consider who he is and where he came, it's a great example of humility tonight. Amen. And then we see him in verse number 7, not only as the Savior and as the Son, he's seen as the Messiah, he's seen as the Maker, but when you get to verse number 7, we see him as the servant. Amen. We see him as the man, as the Bible said, that he made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant. Think about this. From verse 5 to the early part of verse 7, we have seen Christ go from being the sovereign to being the Son to now being the servant. Amen. I'm talking about, you can see the example of humility in this text. You can see the mind of him as he goes from being the mind of the Messiah to being the Maker to now he's humbled himself and he's become the man, the Son of Man, the Bible talks about. You think about the humility of our Savior to lower himself to servitude in a world that he'd already created, into a world of fallen, sinful humanity. But Jesus humbled himself and became a servant and made himself of no reputation. There's a lot of people today that, listen, they build their lives and they build their ministries and they build everything they have off of reputation. I'll tell you, reputation is what people think you are, but character is who you really are. And Jesus, my friend, in his character, he was still sovereign. He was still the Son of God when he walked in this world, but he didn't go around tooting his own horn. He didn't go around letting everybody know. No, I tell you, the Bible tells us that he made himself low. He made himself of no reputation. Hallelujah. Well, we can have revival if we can live in that mindset, can't we? That we don't have to be seen. We don't have to be recognized. We don't have to be elevated. We don't have to be cheered on. We don't have to be lifted up. That's the attitude. That's the mindset. We don't have to be number one. We don't have to be first. We don't have to receive the best. We don't have to be the best. We just ought to give our best. Isn't that right? I'm telling you, God blesses those who stay little in their own eyes. He blesses those who humble themselves. The Bible said there's seven things the Lord doth hate, and the first one that tops the list is a proud look. God resisteth the proud, but he giveth grace to the humble. And can I tell you something this evening? I would rather have grace as to have a trophy any day. I'd rather have grace as to have recognition any day. I don't need recognition. It's not going to do me a bit of good. But every day I roll out of bed, every day I open my eyes, every second I live in this world, you know what I need? And can't do without. I need the grace of God. Amen. I'll take the grace of God over anything that anybody could ever offer. But in order to have that, you've got to make yourself of no reputation. Amen. So many times, if we're not careful, we can let this flesh get in the way of things and do things and just want to be recognized. And I understand encouraging each other. We need to do that. I'm not minimizing that. I'm just telling you, my flesh and your flesh, this flesh tonight, it doesn't matter what personality it's wrapped up in, but the flesh can only handle so much praise. Very little praise. Can I tell you that? The flesh, listen, God will let you have enough encouragement and recognition in this life to get you over the next hilltop, but can I say this? The flesh can't handle too much of that praise because it'll blow it up, it'll puff it up, it'll ruin you. Amen. If you get a hold of it, you've got to dismiss that and not make yourself of any reputation. Amen. You say, Brother Gravely, how do you keep that from happening? Well, this is the only way I know how. The only way I know how to do that is to every day remind yourself. And for me to remind myself, we're servants. We've been called to serve. Amen. It's Pastor Appreciation Month. And I'll tell you, I appreciate the kindness that I've been overwhelmed by the cards, the thank yous, things that people have done. My wife and me both have. And I'll tell you why we have. Because we know we don't deserve anything. I'm not saying that to... I'm telling you that from the bottom of my soul tonight. I know where I ought to be at. I ought to be in hell. I don't deserve anything. And I tell you, every time one of God's people does something, anything, I'm telling you, when somebody slips me a note and says something, the kids in the class rooms wrote some little notes, and I went through those notes and read them. I'm going to tell you, it was a humbling experience because I know how sorry and low down, and for them to take the time just to write something down and tell you that they love you and that they appreciate you, to give you something like that, it means the world to me, because I know that I don't deserve that tonight. And what are you saying? This is what I'm saying to you tonight, that you and I, we have to go through this life and remember that God put us here on this earth and he saved our souls, but he saved us for a purpose in mind, and that is to serve God and serve for the greater good and to serve humanity, to bring the gospel. And they people don't owe me nothing tonight. You don't owe me anything. I'm telling you, thank God for what this church has done for me. But the truth is, you don't owe me another thing in this life. I'm telling you, God has blessed me more than I ever deserve. I don't have, Brother Laddie, a large bank account. I don't have some fat retirement. But I'll tell you, I got a retirement that's out of this world, because he lifted me out of the dung hills of this old sinful world, and he wrote my name, thank God, in the Lamb's Book of Life. And if he never blessed me again, if he never pass by my way again, he's done more than I ever deserve. He's done more than I ever expected him to. And I ought to spend the rest of my days blessing his holy name. Hallelujah. He's worthy tonight, isn't he? God oftentimes uses people that will always remember where they came from. And I'll tell you tonight, as a Christian, we must always remember where we came from. I heard a young pastor. He had a pastor appreciation day. And I heard him complaining because he felt like that the church should have done more. I didn't say anything to him when he said it, but he got more than I got my first few years. But it wasn't none of my business. But I thought to myself, God's people don't owe us anything. I'm telling you, I preach it. And I tell you, sometimes I feel bad preaching it because, Brother David, I don't want the devil to tell somebody I'm preaching it to fatten my pocketbook, but I think you know me well enough to know I wouldn't do that. But I preach it because one day I'm going to be gone, and whoever comes behind, I want that man of God to be taken care of. And you say, well, I believe that, yes, but there's younger ones coming up, and they have to hear it, and I sure ain't going to ask somebody to come in and preach it, amen. I mean, what would that be to say, I need you to come preach on giving the preacher a raise and taking care of him, you know? That might look bad, and so I just preach it because it's got to be preached. It's the whole council, but I don't want to preach it. It needs to be said, doesn't it? And you do a great job. I don't say it because that you need to do it. I say it because it has to be said. But I'll say this tonight, that God's people, they don't owe us preachers nothing. You know why I'm at this church? Because almost 25 years ago, 24 and a half years ago, God called me to this church. And when he called me, I never asked the deacon board one time what they were going to pay me. It came up later. But the only thing I was interested in is this the will of God for my life? And it was, and it is. And as long as it is, it wouldn't make no difference tonight, would it? Now, don't cut my salary, okay? Y'all just keep it coming, all right? Miss Gravley has to go to Walmart every now and then. But I'm telling you the truth tonight is that if you couldn't pay me, if Biden stays in office, you may not be able to pay me another dime. He shouldn't have been in there anyway. Can I get an amen? He didn't win. Let me look around for a Democrat. If you believe he won, listen, I got 15 acres on the moon I'll sell you. Dirt cheap. Amen. He didn't win. I don't know. It just frustrated me this week, so I need to get that out. Amen. But having said that, if you couldn't pay me another dime, if God didn't, I would just keep on preaching. Because God called me here. You say, what would you do? I'd go get a job. Because, you know, sometimes a good job might be a stress reliever. I'd get me a job where I was using a hammer every day. Beating something just sounds good, don't it? Not you, something. I'm just trying to make some of y'all laugh a little bit. But I'm going to tell you, it's not who. Well, praise God. I'm telling you, if that one can get it, everybody in the building ought to get it. I'm telling you. Gonna make him a deacon, praise God. But you know something? No reputation. It's not about a name. It's not about tonight what people think and how many people can know you in this life. I tell you, it's about serving God tonight. I tell you, serving God's the best thing that ever happened to any of us. Sometimes God will put you in places and that nobody will ever see you there. And how long you stay there, I can tell you how long you're going to be there until you get to the place in life that it doesn't matter if you stay there the rest of your life. And when you get to the place you're happy doing that with nobody seeing what you're doing, and then he may just leave you there because that's always a good place to be. And then he may have you stay there a little longer. But I'll tell you, friend, when you get to the place when and reputation doesn't matter, but service is what matters. When you're serving God, I'm going to tell you, service is not based on results. Service is not based on reputation. Service is not based on rewards. Service is not based on recognition. But service is based on one thing. It's based on pleasing the master that has called you to serve. And if the master is pleased, then it's a job well done at the end of the day. Are you serving your master? Hallelujah. See, some people can teach a class if it's full, but they struggle if it's empty. Some people can preach to a church if it's full, but have a hard time if it's empty. But Jesus here, I see the service of this man. I see the sacrifice of him. The message, notice what the Bible says here, that he was made in the likeness of men. Notice verse number 8. And being found in fashion as a man, look at this, he humbled himself. Oh, when I think about Christ humbling himself, I think about the discipline in that phrase there. He humbled himself. Jesus, by his own discipline, he humbled himself. I want to tell you, humility does not come natural for any of us. We must discipline ourselves to humble ourselves, to keep the mind of a servant. We must talk to ourselves. We must remind ourselves who he is and who we are. That's why worship is so important in every day of our life, that we worship God, because worship keeps God in his rightful place in our life, and it keeps us in our rightful place in our life. I see the discipline here as Christ humbled himself, and I see here not only the discipline, but I see the dedication, how that he became obedient unto death. Oh, the depth of that dedication, how that Christ was willing to not just be obedient, but to be obedient unto death. And then notice the degree there. The Bible says even the death of the cross, Jesus was willing to come and to go through the most greatest and gruesome brutality that any man could ever face. He was not just willing to die, but he was willing to face the cross. He was willing to go to Golgotha. He was willing to go to Calvary. He was willing to suffer like no man had ever suffered before. Oh, what an example of humility tonight. I see it in his sacrifice. To humble ourselves requires it. Then not only the example, but notice the exaltation of this humility. Wherefore, verse 9, God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is, and it still is, by the way, above every name. You know why God exalted him? Because of his humility. The Father hath committed all judgment unto the Son. Christ, heaven is going to be about Christ. The center theme of heaven, it's song, it's worship, it's, listen, it's theme, it's anthem. Everything about heaven is going to be about the Lamb. John looked, and in the midst of that throne, what did he see? He saw the Lamb, amen, that had been slain from the foundation of the world. I'll say, thank God, worthy is the Lamb tonight. He is worthy tonight. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be sung about. He's worthy to be lifted up. He's worthy to be glorified. He's worthy to be magnified. He's worthy to testify. He's worthy to shout about. He's worthy, thank God, to witness about. Christ is worthy. He is the Lamb of God. His name is above every name. There's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. Oh, what a name. The precious, the holy, the lovely, the wonderful, the glorious, the majestic. I'm telling you, the most beautiful name. It is his name. It is a wonderful name. It is God's name. It's heaven's name. It's Jesus. Hallelujah tonight. Woo, hallelujah. If I had a voice, I'd shout, praise God. I'm telling you, worthy is his name. There is not a name like the name of Jesus. Amen. There is no other name tonight. His name is above every name. Oh, in the stillness of the night, it's the name of Jesus. In the depths of the valley, it is the name of Jesus. On the mountaintop, it is the name of Jesus. I'm telling you, in the darkness of the midnight hour, I'll tell you what'll speak peace to your soul is the precious, the lovely, the wonderful, oh, thank God, the holy, the heavenly, name Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. You can start talking about Jesus and you'll quit preaching and start worshiping. Amen. I'm telling you, I just love his name. It's fairer than 10,000. Amen. It's more greater than the rubies and the diamonds of this world. It's sweeter than the honey that comes out of the comb. I'm telling you, his name, it'll pick you up when you're down. It'll lift you up when you're falling. It'll get you through the next valley. It'll see you over the next hilltop. I say worthy. Worthy. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. It's his name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Woo! What a name tonight. His name. I'm telling you, church can be deader than 4 o'clock. And you just start talking about his name. The preaching can be drier than cracker juice. But you just start talking about his name. Some of y'all have come alive. Amen. You know why? Because you heard that name. That name that shakes the foundation of hell. That name that causes demons to tremble. That name that pulls sinners out of the clutches of death. That name that lifts someone out of the dunghill of this world. That name that takes someone out of the gutter and puts them in the choir. Oh, that name that takes someone off dope and gives them hope. That name that rescues one from the depths of religion. That name that picks me up when I'm falling. That name that encourages me to go on another mile. That name, I just can't get it out of my system. It helps me when I need help. It's that name. And we pray in that name. We worship in that name. It's his name. Hallelujah. Woo! Praise God. Woo! Hallelujah. Bless his name. Glorify his name. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Woo! Praise God. Woo! Bless his name. Woo! Oh, yes. That name, when you prayed and felt like you can't get through, but you just pray in his name. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. 1,000 times amen. What a name. There's power in that name. There's peace in that name. There's joy in that name. There's blessing in that name. There's salvation in that name. There's mercy in that name. There's grace in that name. There's goodness in that name. Y'all are going to have to help me because I'm about to die. Praise God for the name. Oh, what a lovely name. The name of Jesus. Oh, bless his name tonight. Woo! Thank God for that name. Oh, that name that'll rescue the fallen. That name that'll be there just in the nick of time. That name that will work on Judgment Day. That name that one day every knee is going to bow. And that every tongue and every nationality is going to confess that that name, that Jesus Christ is Lord. There's comfort in that name. I'm telling you, that name's helping me right now. I hope that name's helping you right now. I'm telling you, if you got a problem, if you just pray that name tonight, if you got a need tonight, the answer's in that name. The resources are in that name. The hope is in that name. I'm telling you, that name brings a miracle. That name, thank God, will work when nothing else will. That name will help you in the midnight hour. Praise God. It's that name that'll be there for your children and for your grandchildren. It's that name that makes a service come alive. Why? Because it's above every name. What about people in church that want to make a name for themselves rather than that name? You know, I see these singers, these gospel singers. You don't have to have, if you have the brain of a gnat, if there's somebody here, if your brain is the size of a gnat, well, I got some good news for you. You can look at some of these gospel singers. You don't even got to hear them sing. You can look at them and tell who they're all about. They're all about self. I mean, I'm telling you, if you pulled up here tonight and there was a big bus out here with their faces running down the side of it, and then you come in here and they had cardboard cuttings of all of them standing there with fake smiles on. Amen. And they're shaking your hand, smiling like a possum with cigarette breath. Come on now. Because they just flipped one in the parking lot before they came in. You say, why do you say that, preacher? Because it aggravates me sometimes. If you want to go downtown and pay $15 and waste your money and watch them put on a show, that's okay. It's clean entertainment. But I'll tell you, if people come to church, this is not a stage. And preachers are as bad as singers. I'm not just on singers. But I'm telling you tonight, humility, the example of it, was seen in the greatest name that the world has ever known. Jesus humbled himself, became as low as a man could ever become because he loved me and you. I won't finish the sermon tonight, but I want to say what a great example. What a great example tonight of humility. Lord, help me tonight. Help me tonight to never think I deserve anything. To never think I've earned anything. Well, they sat in my seat at church. They got my pew. They sung my song. They preached my sermon. None of it's ours tonight. I tell you, this isn't my pulpit. You're not my people. This isn't my church. I know we sometimes haphazardly say those things, but this pulpit don't belong to me, does it? Somebody had it before I came, and somebody will have it when I'm dead and gone. This church, it don't belong to me. It belongs to God. Isn't that right? I'm a member of it. You're a member of it. But it's his church tonight. You're his people. You belong to him, and I belong to him. We're his people tonight. We're his people. What a great Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Here it is, humility. Serve the Lord. How are we to do that? With gladness. I'll tell you something. Getting up every day knowing that serving Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to you. That'll make your day different. I was here at the school the other day, and some kid stopped the toilet up. I started to call somebody because I didn't want to do that. You can go ahead and laugh, it's all right. I got the plunger, and the devil met me there at that porcelain altar. He is standing there waiting on me. This is almost 25 years, and look where it got you. I said, devil, it'd be good for me to plunge this toilet because it'll remind me of the grace of God in my life. I'm going to tell you something, serving God, I don't care what it is. I don't care if it's vacuuming the carpet. I don't care if it's plunging the toilet. I'm going to tell you something tonight. It's a privilege. It It's a privilege. It's not a right tonight. It's a privilege to be where you're sitting and where I'm standing tonight. It's a privilege to be here. I tell you, when something needs done at church, we ought to all be knocking each other out of the way to get it done. That God would let us be a part of such a great work for His glory. Isn't that a blessing tonight to be in this church, to cut the grass, to clean the bathrooms? I'm telling you, to sing in the choir. It's a privilege tonight that God's given us. Lord, help me to never think I deserve anything, Lord. Help us tonight. Help us to stay humble as we stand. The Bible said we have to be clothed with it. You know how you're clothed? You have to get up every day. You have to take something off and put something on. Isn't that right? You have to take off that old clothing and go put on that garment. God said, there's a garment I want every child of God to wear. It's the garment of humility. Just get up every day and just clothe yourself in it. Just put it on. How do you do that? In prayer, thanksgiving. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before His presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, He is God. Not me, but He is God. And there were His people and the sheep of His pasture. Here's how you get clothed with humility. Enter into His gates with thanksgiving. Lord, thank you for this day. Lord, thank you for saving my soul. Lord, thank you for giving me a good job. Lord, thank you for a good church to go to. Thank you for a good wife, good husband, children. Lord, thank you for the opportunity to serve you today. Thank you for health and strength. Thank you for the ability to be in my right mind, to put my clothes on. Thank you, Lord, for the ability to dress myself. Thank you, God. Clothed with humility. Enter into His gates with thanksgiving, and it won't be long. You'll be in His courts with praise. And be thankful unto Him, and bless His name. For the Lord is good, His mercy is everlasting, and His truth endureth to all generations. If you need to come while we sing, you obey God tonight.
Dear, so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word.
Isn't that a privilege tonight?
Just to rest upon His promise.
What a great example.
Just to know, thus saith the Lord.
Amen. Let's sing it, church.
Jesus,
that name.
Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
I always sing another verse, you obey God.
Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust His cleansing blood, just in simple faith to plunge me beneath the healing cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Amen. All God's people said, we're going to be dismissed in a word of prayer. And we hope you have a wonderful work week. We'll be praying for you. And don't forget Wednesday night, 7 o'clock. Let's pray for the service on Wednesday night. And look forward to you being in the Lord's house. We're going to be dismissed in prayer at this time. But let me do this. If you have signed up for our Christmas play, if you'll go ahead and slip out and just go over to the fellowship hall. We don't want to take up any of your time. We'll slip out and just have a 5-minute meeting. And then also, if you're a preacher and you are
a preacher in the church like for you to slip out as well, so we can just at least take just a moment, present this ministry here, and so that if there's an interest there for you to be a part of it, if your time or schedule works out, we want to give you that opportunity as well, all right? While these folks are slipping out, let's be dismissed in a word of prayer at this time. Brother Jeff Babb, if you would, dismiss us in prayer, brother.